Hello everyone, my name is Lalit Kumar and I am working as an art conservator with INTAC. Today I am going to discuss about an oil painting case study, conservation of a heavily deteriorated oil painting portrait. We will be discussing in general the methodology undertaken for conservation of this portrait. Paintings are not merely painted surfaces. Paintings are complex, three-dimensional structures composed of a variety of materials combined in an infinite number of ways. All these layers have their own functions to perform, like auxiliary support, primary support, sizing, ground, paint layer, and surface coating. Oil painting. The basic definition of an oil painting is a painting wherein pigments are bound with a medium of drying oil, such as linseed oil, poppy seed oil, in the paint applied to a support. Sometimes a thinner is also added to the viscous paint to make oil mixture easier to apply with a brush. The history of oil painting has included the use of different support such as wood, plyboard, metal plates. However, a thin linen or cotton canvas support is most popular. Process of drying. Unlike tempera, acrylic paint, or watercolor, which dry by evaporation of water or solvents, oil paint dry by complex oxidation and polymerization of the drying oil, meaning the drying oil react chemically with oxygen in the air and gradually cross-linking of the long polymer chains take place, and the medium changes from a liquid to a gel and finally become a firm film. This process of drying oil takes a lot of time, months or even years. Now we are moving to the description of the painting. An oil on canvas portrait was received in a rolled condition for restoration from a private collector. This most probably is a portrait of Maharaja Mahip Narayan Singh of Banaras. He was a ruler of princely state of Banaras from 1781 to 1794 under the British rule. We identified the portrait with the help of his turban and jewelry wearing style. This painting seems to be executed in early 20th century. Sample collection. Before starting the restoration of any oil painting or object, it is of utmost importance to acquire a thorough knowledge of its material composition and how it will react to the various treatment. Therefore, there are different invasive and non-invasive techniques to gain important information regarding oil painting material and execution technique. In this particular case, invasive technique was applied to gain information about the painting. A minute sample was collected with the help of microscope and scalpel for microscopic cross-sectional study. Cross-section study. This method involves the removal of minute samples from the painting to be embedded in polyester resin. The investigation of the microstructure of a painting from the examination of embedded paint sample under an optical microscope provide the conservator with the fundamental understanding of the materials, layers, and technique of the painting. In this particular case, we were able to identify presence of ground, different layers of paint, and a thick layer of natural varnish. Condition assessment. The process of restoration start with the mapping and documentation of condition of the art object. This is a continuous process and a record needs to be kept of all stages of conservation. Examination or detailed identification of damages and the actual causes behind the damages was undertaken. The painting was received in heavily deteriorated condition. It had suffered from neglect and poor storage condition for many years. The painting was received in rolled condition. Stretcher was missing. After detailed examination of backside of the painting, it looks like the wooden stretcher may have been badly damaged or totally eaten away by insect, most probably termites. The canvas support as well as the paint layer also showed sign of damage due to insect attack. Due to moisture penetration, canvas had also become very fragile and brittle. The edges were weak, frayed, and lost. In this detailed picture, we can notice residue of termite infestation as well as areas of canvas eaten away by insect. The painting is very old and had a natural varnish coating that had turned yellow with time due to polymerization and oxidation process. Blanching was also noticed. Blanching is caused by trapping of moisture in varnish layer, causing a change in refractive index or opacity in the otherwise transparent varnish layer. Cracks were also observed in the paint layer. However, these cracks were not aging cracks as expected, but those caused by expansion and contraction of canvas due to rapid change in humidity and temperature or exposed to moisture. This had also led to the flaking and loss of paint layer due to moisture penetration to the ground and loosening the bond or adhesion between paint layer and ground as well as with canvas support. Flaking was also due to mechanical damage and insect attack. Due to rolling or other mechanical damages and insect attack, there were many losses in the canvas support. Conservation methodology. Intact Conservation Institute, Delhi, specialized in undertaking conservation of all kind of object such as painting, sculpture, textiles, paper objects, and taxidermy. I will be discussing the conservation methodology adopted at ICI. The conservation treatment involved cleaning and removal of yellowed varnish, consolidation of the paint layer, mending of losses, stabilization of the canvas support with relining, reintegration of losses in the painting, and application of a varnish layer. Facing. Facing is necessarily a temporary measure, and it is done to protect the paint layer from further flaking and crumbling during the handling process for treatment. The painting had suffered damage due to exposure to moisture, hence water-soluble adhesives were not preferred. BIVA 371, a solvent-based adhesive, was chosen for facing. Also, this solution was to be used to consolidate the paint layer. So that was an added advantage. Japanese tissue paper was used for facing with BIVA 371. Mechanical cleaning. After completing the process of facing, mechanical cleaning was done to remove the thick layer of dust and dirt, accretion of insect infestation on the reverse side of the canvas with the help of soft brush and Bishop sponges. Bishop sponges are basically synthetic latex which helps in gentle cleaning. Full consolidation. During assessment of painting's condition, it was observed that painting required a full consolidation due to the poor adhesion between the canvas, ground, and paint layer. BIVA 371 was chosen as the adhesive due to its flexibility, known hygroscopic nature, and good penetration strength. The warm BIVA solution was applied to the back of the canvas, and traditional hot iron was used with a vacuum envelope setup for providing heat for penetration. Solvent cleaning. During the microscopic examination of cross section of paint layer, a thick layer of natural varnish was observed. This varnish layer has turned yellow due to aging. Solvent cleaning was done to remove this layer of varnish without disturbing the paint layer. To enhance the aesthetic appearance of painting, different stages of cleaning photograph shows the cleaning process and the change in aesthetic appearance. Mending. Inserts using new matching pieces were prepared using canvas of similar strength and thickness and inserted in missing section of the canvas to obtain straight line and recreating missing canvas parts. These extensive areas of structure repairs along with weakened areas in the canvas such as fold mark and creases were temporarily reinforced by thin strips of muslin cloth and heat sealed adhesive at the reverse of the painted canvas. Lining of the canvas support. The lining process is described as a method by which a new cloth material is adhered to the back of a painting whose canvas has weakened to such an extent that it can no longer support itself. Lining was opted as the original canvas was very fragile condition and had many losses. A support canvas chosen on the basis of strength of original canvas and biwa was applied with brush on the side to be adhered onto the back of the painting canvas. This whole process was done under a vacuum suction setup with application of heat to regenerate the adhesive. Filling. All the losses in the canvas were filled with a white gesso putty to bring them to the level of the surrounding original paint. The image shows the painting at the end of this stage. Loose lining and stretching of painting. After completing the putty filling process, a support fabric, in this case marking cloth, was stretched on a new stretcher before stretching the painting canvas with lining. This fabric will protect the painting canvas from dust, dirt, and also from direct contact with the stretcher edges. The painting was then stretched on the stretcher over the loose lining. Reintegration of losses. Retouching was done using water-based colors. Finally, a layer of protective coating was given to the painting. This synthetic polymer protective coating layer, besides protecting the painted surface, also has the added benefit of not yellowing for a long time. Now I am showing you some photographs of the painting before and after conservation, showing not only stabilizing the active deterioration that was happening on the painting, but restoring the painting back to its original glory. INTEC Conservation Institutes are located at different parts of the country and dedicatedly working on conservation and restoration of various forms of art objects, which range from paintings, textiles, wooden objects, stone objects, and wall painting. For further information, the details of the centers are provided here. Please like this video and subscribe to our channel for more information on conservation of different art forms that required scientific expertise in conservation and restoration. You can also view our previous upload on ICI lecture series Conservation Insight 2020. conservation of cast and wrought iron, surface preparation and painting by Geoffrey Wallace. Thank you for your attention.